SSNIT statement by the Professional and Managerial Staff Union, PMSU, and the local union of PBC PLC, which is under the Industrial and Commercial Workers Union, ICU. And this statement is dated July 18, 2024. So those of us here are the cross-section of the national executives of the PMSU and the local union. So I am the national chairman of the Professional and Managerial Staff Union. The name is Cosmas Terkemore.
And then I'm Diabo Sidi, national chairman, local union.
Boku Ata Kankam Simia, first trustee, PMSU, PBC.
Good. So we take this opportunity to welcome all the executives here present. We also welcome our friends from the media. PBC PLC is the only licensed buying company, LBC, in Ghana, in which the people of Ghana have majority stake. The government of Ghana, through the Ministry of Finance and the Social Security and National Insurance Trust, SSNIT, own 74.7% share in the company. Ministry of Finance, 36.69%, and SSNIT, 38.1%. In years past, it was the only cocoa buyer in Ghana, that is PBC. The company currently employs about 700 permanent workers and over 15,000 casual workers. Since its establishment in 1999, there has been no working capital. It relied on allocations of part of the syndicated loans from Cocoa Board at concessionary rates. That notwithstanding, in 2010 and 2011, PBC placed first in the prestigious Ghana Club 100 ranking of companies. Unfortunately, the fortunes of the company in subsequent years witnessed periods of major decline until the current season, that is the 2023-2024 main crop season, when the company could not buy a single bean of cocoa. The current poor performance of the company has brought untold hardship upon the workers of PBC. The following is a brief outline of some of the ways in which the workers have been impacted. No salary increments for the past 8 years. Non-payment of salary for 11 months and more in the case of staff with special issues. Unpaid deductions from salaries for provident fund contributions, that is PF 1 and 2, Tier 3, workers' welfare fund, union dues, dues for other groups and associations in the company, among others. Non-payment of inconvenience allowance to staff on transfer, unpaid medical bills, and inability of workers to receive treatment from Cocoa Clinic before the company settles the bill later, as it used to be the case, and unpaid benefits and exit packages to staff who are on retirement, have resigned, or have their appointments terminated, as the case may be. There are other benefits and entitlements under the collective agreement which should have been paid to some workers, but due to the current challenges of the company, the workers are not receiving them. As a result of these challenges, some workers have sadly lost their lives because they could not afford basic health care. Workers with chronic medical conditions are unable to purchase their medications. Many workers are unable to cater for their family needs and a myriad of other unmet social demands. Government support. In 2019, the workers of PBC, through the Industrial and Commercial Workers Union, ICU, requested for government support to ring fence the debt of the company to enable it access credit from the banks. This request was not granted, but rather the government gave PBC comfort letters season after season to enable it access seed funds from Ghana Cocoa Board. The seed funds were usually allocated several weeks after the season opened and was normally inadequate. This led to considerable decline in the purchases of PBC. Given the high fixed costs and the decline in revenue due to low purchases, the company's performance worsened. From the beginning of the 2023-2024 May till the close of the main crop season in June 2024, no funds were allocated to PBC. It was only recently that some funds were released by Cocoa Board for the light crop season. It was the expectation of workers that at the time funds were being released for the light crop purchases, the outstanding salaries should have been paid. Giving money to a worker who has not received salary for 11 months is tantamount to leading them into temptation. We also acknowledge with appreciation the support government gave PBC to enable it reach a settlement with the banks that were given a court order to sell the properties of PBC to defray the debts owed them. This action by the government has saved the company from imminent collapse. However, a lot more support is required to keep the company in business. Appeal to the government. PBC indigenous companies can be profitable, and we know PBC has the capacity to bounce back and take its rightful place if the necessary support is provided. We are appealing to the government to support PBC with a bailout. For the company to remain in business in the short to medium term, it should be assisted to 1. Pay salaries of workers. 2. Reorganize and reposition the business. 3. Obtain working capital for its operations. And 4. Ring fence its debt to enable it access credit. Management of PBC PLC. As workers of PBC, we are wondering what exactly the management is managing. For the first time in the history of the company, we have not bought cocoa in the main crop season. Our appeal to the government is that if the necessary resources cannot be mobilized for PBC to continue operations, there is no need keeping government appointees as leaders of the company. In conclusion, we are grateful to all members of the union for being part of this event. We also thank our friends from the media for the coverage. We remain united in purpose for our common cause of fighting for the survival and sustenance of our beloved company. We thank you all.
Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and click on the bell for more updates.